Good morning, everyone. It's so lovely to see you on this really lovely spring-like day. The Lord be with you and also with you. Now, just a few words of welcome. Obviously, it's a big day for the family, for Bonnie, and we're excited to be together with the godparents and family and friends. Welcome to you all. Just a few little notices. I think you might have seen the sign on the door when you came in that this service is being live streamed. So if you'd rather not be in view of the camera, just sit to the left or to the right. Then you will avoid the camera. There is a loo at the back. I'm afraid there's only one, so don't all rush at once. We're going to have a collection, but we'll do it at the end. So and there is a card machine as well if you'd want to use that. We want you to feel at home. We are part of a family here. And that's why we come on a Sunday. We do this baptism on a Sunday because we are inviting Bonnie to be part of our family. So you are all very welcome. Feel at home. You've got a service sheet and a hymn sheet. That's all you need. You don't need a hymn book. Hopefully it's all fairly self-explanatory. So as we start, we acknowledge the fact that the Holy Spirit, God, is here with us. And so we say this opening prayer. Heavenly Father, by the power of your Holy Spirit, you give to your faithful people new life in the water of baptism. Guide and strengthen us by the same Spirit, that we who are born again may serve you in faith and love and grow into the full stature of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I'm going to light the candle here, which is our Easter candle. And we do this because this is obviously a very special occasion. But sometimes on these occasions, we have friends who can't be with us, absent friends, and we want to remember them as well. And we particularly remember Anne Williams, who was a very special godparent to Lou.
Good morning, everyone. Can I add my welcome to Joe's? It's really good to see you all this morning. We're going to sing in a moment, sing our first hymn. And it's a song which you might not know, maybe you do. But if you don't worry. We're going to play it through once in a moment just to get the tune in our heads. But it's a great song to sing at this Easter time of year, the season of Easter. As we have our Easter candle lit, that light is shining among us. And we're going to be thinking this morning about what it means to be people who gather around the light of Jesus, what it means to be a community. And I wonder how you are with collective nouns, collective nouns for animals, for instance. Anyone know what you call a group of owls? I heard it. Go on. You said it.
Go on.
A parliament. A parliament of owls. Do you know what you call a group of elephants? Well, it can be a herd, but there is actually a specific collective noun. It is, and funny because we don't think of elephants this way, but it's a memory of elephants. A memory of elephants. Crows, anyone? A murder of crows, well done. Seems a bit unfair, doesn't it? A murder of crows. Hamsters. Anyone for hamsters?
Nuisance.
A nuisance of hamsters. Well, quite, yeah. It is, in fact, a horde of hamsters. There are many more. What do we call, though, a group of people gathered around the light of Jesus? It is, of course, all of us. It is a church, not a building, not a place we go to do things, but a community of people gathered around Jesus. And so our first hymn picks this up. It's called Come People, all of us, community of the risen King, who delight to bring him praise. So Colin's going to play it through for us once. If you know it, hum along. If you can only manage the chorus, go with the chorus. Let's all sing this together. There are also some instruments, and it is often quite fun for people, big or small, to have a go with an instrument. So two, you're going for that. Well done. I like a volunteer. Pass them around. Colin, let's hear this hymn through. We've got it, we've got it. Let's stand together and sing as people of the risen King. Yeah, we'll go back to verse one.
Let's now sit and hear our reading.
Can I just say as well, as Mary's coming to read to us, listen out as you hear this reading. She's going to read it beautifully, and there are words in here that might jump out at you. We're going to come back to those in the talk afterwards. So just listen out for any words that might jump out to you. Thank you, Mary.
The reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24. The 11 apostles are in an animated discussion following the recent news of the appearance of Jesus on the road to Emmaus. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." This is the word of the Lord.
So let me pray before we think about this passage. Lord Jesus, we ask you now to come into our presence, to help us see you more clearly and follow you more nearly and love you more dearly, day by day. Amen. Amen. So, when you were listening to that passage being read by Mary, I wonder what words or phrases or images did jump out at you in that description of a group of people gathered around Jesus in that room. Is anyone brave enough to offer something that they noticed? Animated discussion. Yes, there was lots of discussion going on. That's what happens in church sometimes. People talk about what it's like to be a follower of Jesus. Did anyone else pick up a phrase? Amanda? Witnesses, thank you. Witnesses, at the end there, sorry, I'm losing my voice here. At the end, Jesus says, "You are witnesses." He's talking to people gathered just like us. He says, "You are witnesses," and that word in the original language of the Bible is martyr, martyros. A witness is a martyr, someone who gives away their life. Now, we're not called to necessarily to die physically, at least not in this country, but we might be called to die spiritually, to give away something of our life to show other people what Jesus is like. Any other words that jumped out? Any other pictures?
I think they must have been quite animated at the time, but it sort of didn't realise the cost of what it was going to be to share the gospel, which is part of the early
Okay.
church.
They didn't perhaps, they didn't fully understand what was going on. Did you hear? They said at one point, in their joy, they were, sorry, I've lost it. Where's it gone? In their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. So it can be both things at the same time. We can be having a real celebration, but still have questions. I wonder, hands up, if there's anyone here who's got all of their questions sorted out. No. Good. I'm glad about that. we don't have all of our questions sorted out, even as we gather here today. We can be celebrating, we can still be wondering, we can still be joyful. No one's mentioned the fish. No one's mentioned the fact that Jesus says, anyone got anything to eat? And they give him a piece of fish. Thank you, Tony, that's really kind. Thank you. Why on earth would they give Jesus a piece of fish? I think it's linked to the other word, which no one's mentioned, which is quite striking, which is ghost. They thought he was a ghost. And imagine you're in a room, someone comes through the door that you thought was dead. You might well think he's a ghost. There's a book that was written in the first century AD, a book that gives you some instructions on how to work out if someone is indeed a ghost or not. There are certain tests that you can apply. One of them is check whether their feet are on the floor. Anyone whose feet are on the floor is probably not a ghost. Apparently they tend to hover. The other thing that you do is check for teeth. Ghosts have teeth that work, and they, don't have teeth. Human beings who are alive have teeth, more or less of them, and they can eat. Ghosts don't eat. Jesus asks for something to eat to help show his disciples that he is in fact alive. He's not a ghost. His feet are firmly on the floor. The other thing that really struck me in this passage is the first words that Jesus says, "Peace be with you." Even before they've told him that they've got questions, that they're terrified, that they're doubting, even before they're worried, he says to them, peace. He knows how they're feeling even before they tell him. And peace, as Nelson Mandela famously said, is not just an absence of conflict. It doesn't mean just a place where there's no fighting. Peace, and particularly in Christian terms, means the sort of environment, the sort of life where we can be fruitful, where we can flourish, because we know that in our presence is light that can help deal with our fears. In our presence is the risen Jesus, who's not a ghost, he's real, who helps us to understand what's in the Bible, even when we have questions, who helps us understand who he is, who sends us out to go and tell others, to give away our lives, to serve and to help others know who he is. So just like that first community, all of us here today are a church, collective noun for people who gather around the risen Jesus. There's one obvious difference though. Jesus appeared there, and as far as I can tell, we can't see him here this morning. Or can we? How do we know that the risen Jesus is present? Because that's what Christians believe. How do we touch the hands and feet of Jesus? How do we have our eyes open to recognize him? The very final verse of that passage that Mary read to us tells us that there would be a gift. There would be a gift of the Holy Spirit coming from God, which would make Jesus real in the world. And it's that Holy Spirit which means it's that Holy Spirit that means that we are all bound together as one community of people. Collective noun for Christians is a church. We're all gathered together, bound together by that Spirit. And we're bound together not just here, but all around the world with Christians everywhere. And it's that community that we're welcoming Bonnie into today. the community of the church, people who gather around Jesus all around the world. And it's that same Holy Spirit that helps us to pray. It's that same Holy Spirit that helps us to read the words of this book and to help understand what they mean. It's that Holy Spirit who calms our fears, who comforts us, who gives us inspiration. As we gather today, we pray for the Holy Spirit to be amongst us, doing for us today what that risen Jesus did for his disciples then. There are, on the tables just here, some people, little paper chain people. And if anybody, I'm thinking particularly of smaller people, but it could be anyone, wants to come and decorate one of these people, it would be great if by the end of the service we could make a chain of people. The one thing that I ask is that somewhere in there needs to be a Jesus, so someone could take responsibility for making a Jesus, and there ought to be a Bonnie as well. But if you want to come and colour in one of these, and when we say our prayers, we can add prayers to them as well, then we'll string them together into a community of God's people. A community gathered around the risen Jesus, who is here with us now. Amen.
Thank you, James. Thank you, James. Well, as James was saying, we come to bring Bonnie to baptism. We, family, godparents, parents come, but we all come in a way. We all come together, as James was saying, as a church, to start this special part of this journey with Bonnie and to encourage her in her faith. So the words I'm going to say in a minute, a little bit by way of explanation about what baptism is. And there is a part in this part of the service where all of us as people of God join in. So let's be wholehearted and really get behind Bonnie. So our Lord Jesus Christ has told us that to enter the kingdom of heaven, we must be born again of water and the Spirit, and has given us baptism as a sign and seal of this new birth. Here we are washed by the Holy Spirit and made clean. Here we are clothed with Christ, dying to sin that we may live his risen life. As children of God, we have a new dignity, and God calls us to fullness of life. Faith is a gift of God to his people, and in baptism the Lord is adding to our numbers those whom he is calling. So people of God, will you welcome Bonnie and uphold her in new life in Christ? With the help of God, we will. Now I'd love to call now the parents and godparents up to the front, and Bonnie, having a little moment. If the parents and godparents want to come, and we will wait for Bonnie, that's absolutely fine. This is what happens in families, isn't it? Doesn't always go according to plan. So, parents and godparents, the church receives Bonnie with joy. Today we are trusting God for her growth in faith. Will you pray for her, draw her by your example into the community of faith, and walk with her in the way of Christ?
With the help of God, we will.
I have to say, when we say with the help of God, that's what we really need, isn't it? With the help of God, it's not easy. In baptism, Bonnie begins her journey of faith. You speak for her today. Will you care for her and help her to take her place within the life and worship of Christ Church?
With the help of God, we will.
Now we're going to sing our second hymn on our service sheet, which is One More Step. And as we do that, we will make our way, we will step on this journey towards the font. With children or other family members want to gather around the font, do please come now so you've got better view. So yes, do please come and gather around the font. So parents and godparents, in baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life. So therefore I ask, do you turn to Christ?
I turn to Christ.
Do you repent of your sins?
I repent of my sins.
And do you renounce evil? So I'm going to ask if I've got any volunteers who'd like to help me fill the font with some water. Right. There we go. Who's going to hold it? Would you both like to do it together? There we go. Ready? Get it right over. There we go. Big splash. Whoa. Well done. There we go. Thank you so much. Wonderful. So this is just water, but we're going to bless it now so it becomes special for Bonnie. Praise God who made heaven and earth, who keeps his promise forever. Let us give thanks to the Lord. It is right to give thanks and praise. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ was baptized in the River Jordan, we thank you for the gift of water to cleanse and revive us. We thank you that through the waters of the Red Sea, you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the Promised Land. We thank you that through the deep waters of death, you brought your Son and raised him to life in triumph. Now bless this water, we pray, that your servant who is washed in it may be made one with Christ in her death, in his death and resurrection, cleansed and delivered from all sin and brought to birth in the household of faith. Saving God, give us life.
So brothers and sisters in Christ, the church gathered, let's profess together the faith of the church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
I believe and trust in God.
Do you believe and trust in God, the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe and trust in God.
This is the faith of the church.
This is our faith.
We believe and trust in one God,
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Here we are, just on cue.
Wonderful. Blissfully asleep now. That's fine. Bonnie, Christ loves you and claims you for his own. Receive the sign of the cross. May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness, restore in you the image of his glory, and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen. Will you name this child?
Bonnie Eve Queenie.
Now, would you like to hold her like that and I'll baptise her? Because I think it might be better. Bonnie, I baptise you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bonnie, today God has touched you with his love and given you a place among his people. God promises to be with you in joy and in sorrow, to be your guide in life, and to bring you safely to heaven. In baptism, God invites you on a lifelong journey. Together with all God's people, you must explore the way of Jesus and grow in friendship with God, in love for his people, and in serving others. With us, you will listen to the word of God and receive the gifts of God.
Friends, there is one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Bonnie, by one Spirit we are all baptized into one body. We welcome you into the fellowship of faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you. Should we have a gentle round of applause?
So let's go back to our seats, and as we do so, we will be singing the next hymn, which is Morning Has Broken.
Thank you.
Lovely. Please do sit down. We've welcomed Bonnie into our community of people who meet with Jesus. And one of the first things that we're going to do with her and for her is to pray. And so we come to our prayers. You can see lots of good work being done over here. We'll gather our community of people at the end of our prayers. As we pray this morning, we do so knowing that Jesus is here by his Holy Spirit. He hears all the things that we want to say to him and the things we don't know how to say. And first of all, we pray for the world. Maybe you can imagine in your mind at the moment a place in the world that really needs to know God's light and love, needs to hear those words, peace be with you, and not just to hear them, but to make them real. No doubt many of our minds are turning to the Middle East, to Israel, to the Palestinian territories, to the countries around Israel. We hold the people that live there before God. We hold the people who have power there before God. And we ask that those words, peace be with you, would become a reality because people's hearts are changed from violence to peace. We pray now for the communities of which we're a part, the places we live. And you might want to imagine in your minds now people who live in your house with you, the people who live next door, your neighbours, people you work with, go to school with, play sports with, all the different communities of which we're a part. And as we think about those people, we pray that peace would be with them. And especially we remember anybody among those groups of people, anyone who's ill, anyone who is having a really tough time for whatever reason. Maybe worries about work or money. Maybe worries about children or parents. And we ask that God's Holy Spirit, Spirit of peace and comfort and healing, would be really real to them today. We pray for the church, the community of people gathered around the risen King, the community of which Bonnie is now a member together with us. And we ask that we might learn more and more day by day what it means to live as a community of Jesus' people. We ask for God's help to understand the scriptures. We ask for God's help to show us how to pray. We ask for God's help to serve our neighbours and our communities, to be those witnesses. We ask for God's help where there are things we need to forgive or things that we need to be forgiven of, for the restoring of relationships between each other and with God. We pray for Bonnie, for all those who love and support her, for the life that lies ahead of her, that she might walk in straight paths and on level roads, and that when the bends and the bumps do come, she would know where to turn for support and help and strength. We pray that the light that shines in this place today might go with her and all those who support her, and stay with her all the days of her life. And lastly, we pray for that community of people gathered around Jesus whom we can no longer see. Those we love, but see no more. Those who we are thankful for. Those who shared our lives and showed us the way. And we pray that they might know that peace of Jesus even at the last. And so all these prayers we gather together in the words that Jesus taught us to pray. And if you'd like to join in with the Lord's Prayer, it's on page 8 in your books. We pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. 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 Now, I don't know about you, but I'm very excited to see this community of people that has been created. Rosa, would you like to bring it and show? Wow. Okay. Oh, there's some more here. Look at all these. So this, I'm reliably informed, is Jesus. Is there one in particular that's Bonnie, do we think? Has anyone got a nice picture? Is it that one? Ah, how lovely. Can I show everyone? Here we are. So we've got Jesus and Bonnie right in the middle of this huge crowd of different people, different clothes, different hairstyles, all gathered together. And I think what we might do when the service is finished is perhaps stick all their hands together into a big chain, and then we could hang them on our cross or something like that. Thank you to all the people who've done that. We are a community of all these different people gathered around Jesus. Jesus in the middle, and Bonnie, its newest member. Amen. Braille, thank you.
So we're going to sing our last song, which is probably very well known to many of you. And we still have our tambourine, so we can go out with real joy and gusto. So the last song is This Little Light of Mine. Let's all stand to sing. you. Thank you, Colin. So, as we go out, may the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ Jesus, establish, strengthen, and settle you in the faith. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. Now we have one more thing to do. We have a little gift to give to Bonnie. So I'd love to invite Bonnie and her parents to come out. And we're going to light Bonnie's candle, yeah, from the special candle, the Easter candle. And we're going to present this to Bonnie so that on the anniversary of her baptism, she can relight it. She can relight it on her birthday and other special occasions. So Bonnie, God has delivered you from the dominion of darkness and has given you a place in the light, in the saints in light. Bonnie, as you receive the light of Christ, walk in the light all the days of your life. Shine as light in the world to the glory of God the Father. Go in the light and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. Amen. Should we go out? Colin, perhaps you'd like another round. We'd like all another round of this little light, I think.
Let's get that verse right.
Some more milk or she'll never.
Thank you, James.
No, it's worked twice. Lovely.
Colin's on the cocktail background.
Yeah, I know. Beautiful. Do you know, I don't think I've ever heard you read in church before.
Well, I used to read a great deal when everybody was around.
Yeah.
And he was awfully good, actually, because he did have one or two acquaintances in the Old Vic, I think.